Look at this. We're on the 6th floor already. Yay. Oh wait, what's this? Yay. Floor to, I guess. Hey, down to the 4th floor. Wow. My Pokemon is my loyalty. Okay, but you're locked in this room. But you're fighting us, which means you're a rocket person. Did you accidentally lock yourself in this room? Whatever. I'm just gonna take you out with another flamethrower just to be safe, okay? It's not like it matters. Wow, critical hit. You know, on a quick attack, critical hit probably would have knocked it out, so thanks, game. Thank you. I hate when it gives you those superfluous crits where you're like, I want to make you sure I don't accidentally get my Pokemon knocked out. So I'm gonna do this. I don't want to have to either A, track back to the PC, or B, lose a Pokemon because you're doing a Nuzlocke. We're still following Nuzlocke rules! Yay! Let's see where this one takes us. Wait, wait, wait. Storage is on the 4th and 10th floors, I just realized. What? Why? I'm scared. Oh. Wait, what? That, okay, that's the room we just came from. There we go. What's this one take us? Oh good, he noticed us. Welcome to the 10th floor, so good of you to join me. God, I forgot how much of a maze this place is. Oh, it's so awful. It sucks, Jib. It's just a giant maze of teleporting things and whatnot. We still haven't found the 3rd or 4th Rock Brother, but we haven't gone very far yet, so let's see what we find here. Carbos, good. Carbos, that's nice. An Ultra Ball, that's nice. And a rare, oh wow, we're at 6 rare candies, Jib. We're really set for the Elite Four now. What about you? What do you have to say? Stop moving! Well, wow, Scientist Travis is fighting us, Jib.
Why does everyone hate us?
Probably because we're better than them. We are better than them, it turns out. That's the thing. We're just better than people with Pokemon. Oh, good.
Basically.
Oh, good. Sludge. I felt it coming, and I was like, wait for it. Wait for it. Wait. There we go. Good, we have to use another Hyper Potion to heal up Igos. Okay. No continues. Sir? Rip. Sir, I'm gonna tell you something. To us, we are playing a video game, but you, this is your reality. You are not in a video game. Your reality.
What if his reality is a video game, and we're the players?
No. We're not gonna meditate this girl here. Also, we're not going the gamer here. The gamer is awesome and stuff. Gee, have you read the gamer at all yet?
I'm not actually familiar with what you're talking about.
It's the manga, that I introduced a lot of everyone to. That involves the guy who basically one day wakes up and everything basically works like a video game to him. You know, he's got a he can pull up an inventory where all his items are kept, and it's basically a pocket dimension which holds everything that he wants to put in it. It lets him literally, there's a little number thing which represents his bank account, and he can literally stick his hand into it and pull out money from his bank directly.
Huh.
And he's got stats that when he gets a level up he can increase, and he's got skills and things. And he gets quests if someone requests him to do something. For example, his mom when she requests that he go, you know, pick up groceries or stuff, he gets a quest.
Yeah, I've never heard of this. And then it was silent, because I did not hear of it.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's the basic gimmick, is that because everything works as a game world, to him, he has his own level, and he gets an ability called Detection, which lets him view other people's levels. And it also gives him basic details, like what their class is, etc. And he's looking around, and the average person is between 3 and 5. His teacher's like level 12 or something, because the teacher's a pretty strong badass. And then his best friend is like level 33. The best part is when he looks at his mother. He gets a red skull with a question mark.
That's pretty funny.
And he realizes that a red skull with a question mark only appears if the level difference is greater than like 45. So he doesn't know the exact level difference, but it's something greater than 45. Because his teacher, one of his substitute teachers, is like level 49, and at that point he could see the teacher's level, even though he was only level 6. So it's that type of range. And there's so many other cool things that happen. Because how the various people that have powers fight each other is they basically create pocket dimensions. So they basically create a pocket dimension which copies the immediate area around them. So it basically goes out like 100 feet this way, you know, a few hundred feet in each direction, and makes a pocket dimension of exact copy of that area. So You basically don't get disjointed until you get teleported. And I love what happens. It turns out that there's also those just naturally occurring versions of these that are used for healing and other things. Turns out his power, when he enters into these pocket dimensions, he can make them permanent.
That explains the inventory thing.
Well, yeah, he has an inventory that he can basically use to hide things, and, you know, carry items around him. But the other thing is that when he goes into the pocket dimensions that other people can make, he can make them permanent. They become MMO instance dungeons.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
And this is what, a movie?
No, this is a manga, so it's a novel. And it gets put in there because, you know, of course that comes with its own downsides and drawbacks, namely in the fact that, I'm gonna take the portals back. Namely in the fact that it turns out when you constantly are... There's a lot of things, like, for example, he doesn't take any technical damage. You know, if you hurt him, it hurts, but... So, wait. Wow, that's... Okay, so you're just blaming him. So, you know... So basically, he's not... His capability to fight is not reduced at all until he's dead. Because, you know, video game characters never have their capability to fight get reduced by, you know, damage. You know, there's no fatigue. There may be a stamina meter, but there's no, you know, fatigue.
You know,
accumulate and slow him down. Furthermore, you know, sleeping basically fully heals him, so eating also really heals him. He heals way faster than an old person should. Here's a good one.
Keep in mind, explosion.
Yeah, but Idev's got really high defense. Monsters, when he fights monsters, they draw blue. So,
okay.
This leads to the fact that at one point when he's fighting a zombie, the zombie drops a skill. And he gets the skill Life Drain, which lets him heal himself by hurting others. As a spell. And just other crazy things like that. Because again, his power is he's a game character, so if he touches a skill book, he can immediately learn the skill within it, as long as he meets the requirements.
That's pretty funny.
It's really funny because what is it, his best friend has been learning some martial art technique for all his life. You know, this is the family martial art, it's super powerful, etc. But any person can learn it as long as they learn how to train in it. He touches the book. Whamp. Learns all the contents of it immediately, because again, any person can learn it as long as they have the discipline to learn it. He doesn't need a discipline, because he's just a game character. He just has
great.
To have...
Just great.
It gets, there's just so many crazy things happen. Ooh, good sludge. It's gonna poison again. Wait for it. Oh, no. No poison. Okay. Poison sting. Take it out. Take it out with its own type. High dub. Got it down. It's a really just fun experience. And Idubbbz is 42. Yay.
I cannot stop yawning.
You can. But look at Idubbbz. Look at it. Wow. Scientist tail. Shoot. Okay, what do you have to say? Takeshi Ranch? It's in Russia. It's in Russian no man's land. So Siberia? I mean, that's basically Russian no man's land. Okay, that's a room with... Why are you fighting as if you're a silk employee? I know you're not a silk employee because of that, so okay, let's just beat up your Pokemon. Let's just get the XP from this. What's your team? Oh, good reason. Oh wow, it used tackle on us, Jim. It used tackle. What is this?
Because this is hell.
Okay, wow. Wow. And is that gonna be a poison? Is that gonna be a poison? No. Good. Okay, wow. No. Is he gonna explain why he's not a self-employee or how he attacked us for no reason? Also, why are they teleporters? How are they teleporters? Okay. You know pretty good. Oh good, smoke string. Okay, Idubbbz, just hit one more time. That's all I need from you. That's all I need. Good. Wow. These were so much more easy than Koga's. How did you know I was a rock?
Great.
Okay, either A, he didn't attack us, and we just basically went, no, you're a rocket. Or B, he did attack us, and then asked us how we figured it out. If it's B, then I like to think it's basically we, like, point at him, and then we point, like, a punching motion. He's like, oh, it was attacking you, the tip beat you off. I am one of the four Rocket Brothers. Oh, hey, we found another Rocket Brother, dude.
Nice.
Let's... They all are just called Team Rocket, bro. Oh, kind of sad. Oh yeah, some of the Rockets and Machops and stuff, because Doug's had Machops. Wow. You know, that's one of the things I like is when the bad guy group has an interesting theme, but also is varied in it, you know? The fact that the Rockets are technically very poison ground focused. With the Rattatas and the occasional Machop and stuff. Strangely enough, the Drowsy and Hypno stuff doesn't feel that out of place because it's Drowsy and Hypno are really well known for their poison gas and other moves that are statusy. And I guess it just adds some variety. What do you think? So, Junior, help me please. Help me next thing. It's such a I love that. He's such a coward. The Rockets came and took over the building. Team Rocket's trying to conquer the world with Pokemon. Wow. They must have targeted Silk for our Pokemon products. Okay, well, one more Rocket. On this level, I think, and then we're good. You dare betray Team Rocket? Okay. Scroll back. Scroll back. No. Okay, one, no, we did betray you. Two, we don't work for you. Three, you're thinking of Pokemon Coliseum, where your character quickly was part of the bad guy organization and then left. Because you said, F this shit, I'm out. No thanks.
No thanks.
And that's the entirety of the plot of Coliseum, as your character basically said, either A, no, I don't want you guys to have this because I know what you're going to do with it, and I've had a change of heart, or B, no, I'm going to use this to steal the Pokemon I want to steal, or C, no, I'm going to use it to steal from bad people. And it just, I don't really know, because that's an interesting thing, like, the snag in the ledge is right there. Then Wes just disappears and the second game doesn't have him at all. Which at one point is like, okay, but then we have this really weird thing where we have this really interesting background character that never really got extrapolated on further. Oh look, Felicia can learn agility. Let's see what agility gives us.
We do have to say though that the God, what was his name? He's the best character of the whole series, but I can't remember his name.
Oh, Mirabe? You know, the Ludicolo trainer?
Yes.
Yes. Mirabe is amazing. Okay, what more are we on? You know, let's just take this.
His theme song is still in my head right now.
Yes. Oh yeah, and we take this, and we did this, so we did the 6-4. So that means we go down to the 5-4. Study Pokeball technology on this floor. So, how much Silphclaw was infiltrated by Team Rocket? And or how many of these people are just randomly attacking us? Like, what is going on here? Why are these guys like, yeah, there's some random 10-year-old running around. Beat the shit out of him.
To be fair, it's probably, there's some 10-year-old here. Beat the shit out of him.
But we're being invaded and people are literally threatening employees' lives with death if they don't join Team Rocket. Hey, beat up this 10-year-old.
He seems like a prime target.
I have questions about their logic. Just a lot of things. Also, Yolk is just doing amazing.
Huh.
I just love his nickname, Yolk.
I can't stop yawning.
The secret is we just gotta go. Kill it all at once.
I have been. It's not working.
There's a lot of other crazy things that happen in the game. I need to catch up on it. I'm pretty far behind, actually. Oh, here's the last member of the Team Rocket Brothers, I think. It's just... I'm just psychic there, to be safe. It's just... You know, there's so many things, like, and funny things. For example, he finds out that, like, you know, really pumping his intelligence really high, he becomes super good and can just immediately learn something from a book by reading it once. He may not know exactly what it means, but he's perfectly memorized it. Because he puts his intelligence up to, like, 50 or something. Wait, you're fighting us too? What? There should be an each other. Is just everyone in Silphco just like, yeah, fuck it, there's a kid here? You're a juggler! You are a juggler! Why are you here?
He was the entertainment act for today.
Each seated. There we go. He actually got Leech Seed off on a Kadabra. That's hilarious. Okay, stun sport. I'm just going to put all the status conditions on it. Oh, that's synchronized. Oh, balls. That's so hard. Please don't have another Kadabra after that. Kadabra also doesn't fit with the juggler theme. Why do you... I'm not going to question why Mr. Mime for the juggler, because I can actually understand the Mr. Mime being with the juggler. Because that makes somewhat sense. You know why? You know why, Jib? Mr. Mime makes sense with the juggler?
Why?
Because the juggler can hit the Mr. Mime with a Pokeball from a long distance if it, from a long distance if it gets near a kid. And it can make it look like a trick shot, so if Mr. Mime gets up to anything. Oh, wow. Mr. Mime is a fairly tanky book. But seriously, Mr. Mime looks really weird. Weird and kind of creepy. Hurt yourself, hurt yourself, hurt yourself, hurt yourself, Mr. Mime. Yay! He hurt himself in his confusion. Excuse me. I'm just really confused because I don't want to waste a second. Wow. It is just barely holding on. What do you think, Jake? I don't know either. We still haven't found that gosh dang car key either. But we're clearing out most of this place, so I think we're gonna get to the point where we're gonna have to head back to Pokemon Center though. I'm just getting low on HP and PP and everything else, and I just haven't found a room to rest in and anything else. Oh yeah, this is where they talk about Porygon stuff. Oh yeah, they're talking about this thing. It's a Pokemon report. It's a Pokemon that's been confirmed to evolve when they are traded. Show Team Rocket a little respect.
No, never.
That is, I think that's the biggest challenge of this game. Look at that. It's Papa Frank. He came back from the dead.
Nice.
Well, let's murder him. There we go. He died. Again. Hi, Papa Frank. There we go. Yolk's level 42. Everyone's getting to 40. Yolk's special attack is huge. Herbert up front, because they can use some more love.
It has to be a thing through Skype, because it doesn't pick up on videos.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, we haven't gone here yet. Quit messing with us, kid. Okay. Wow. Really? You're just going to ask me to quit messing with them? I mean, you're Team Rocket, dude. What's in your name? Rockets. you're asking to be messed with. The room is so dirty. You nerds, Rockets. You nerds. Wow, Hypno. Fight it. We ride it on the top. Hypno actually took a bite. And Herbert's still wearing his awesome, the cool shades chip. You know? Sunglasses.
You will never unwear it.
Yeah, we'll never remove the black glasses of Herbert. They make him too awesome. I want fan art of that. I want fan art of Herbert and his... Also, look at Felicia, yes! She's 39! Oh, yes! Oh, I'm so happy. Oh, I want fan art of the final team. That's all I want. Fan art of the final team standing with us.
Probably not gonna get it.
I know. I love it. Let's see, what's over here? Another teleporter pad. This is the one we came from. I'll check out what that one does in a second, but let's see what this guy's saying. I work with Silphco, what am I supposed to do? Help? Stop the Team Rocket people? Okay, yeah, we're gonna go to the Pokemon Center and heal up. And we're just gonna take it before one by one and find the rocket that's got it. We're gonna do that, audience. We're gonna see you next time.